Assalamualaikum, salam sejahtera semua. So in this video, I will explain how to read the phase diagram and explain what is phase diagram all about. So now let's look at the phase diagram of H2O, water. So kalau kita tengok dekat sini ada tiga bahagian ya, solid, liquid dan juga gas. Okay, so kalau kita tengok, line 80 here, separate between solid and gas. So it means that this is the sublimation point. Along this line, this is the sublimation point of H2O. Okay, while line TB represent the melting point because it separate between solid and liquid phase of H2O. Line TC pula shows the boiling point of H2O, where liquid will convert into gas at different temperature and pressure. So sepanjang garisan 80, ini semuanya adalah sublimation point of H2O at certain pressure and temperature. Line TB is the melting point of H2O at certain temperature and pressure. Okay, and also line TC is the melting point, okay, of H2O at certain temperature and pressure. So apa yang berlaku sebenarnya dalam ni? Let's say we have a container of water like in this diagram. This diagram. So asalnya kita ada ice dalam ni. Kita ada ice and we put this ice in a closed container at constant pressure of 180 m. So kalau kita tengok garisan ni at 180 m lah. Okay, so pada asalnya the H2O exists as ice. And then we increase the temperature. Okay, makin ke kanan kan temperature makin bertambah. So finally at this point, solid will convert into liquid. So this is the melting point of H2O. Solid bertukar menjadi liquid. So at this point, there is solid and liquid and at equilibrium. So kalau kita increase lagi temperature dia, okay, makin ke kanan temperature makin increase. So, meaning that we increase the temperature of this container at the constant pressure. So akan tinggal H2O in the form of liquid sepenuhnya dalam container ni. Then we increase the temperature furthermore and we keep constant the pressure at 180 m. So at this point, liquid will convert into gas. So this is the boiling point of H2O at 180 m. Okay, so at this point, there is mixtures of liquid and gas at equilibrium. So, ini boiling point je lah. Suhu dia masa ni 100 darjah Celsius eh. So, if we increase the temperature more towards the right, so dalam container tu nanti akan tinggal gas sepenuhnya. Dah tak ada liquid dah lah. Okay, so kalau contoh kita ambil pula pada pressure yang berbeza. Contoh kita increase the pressure to 280 m. Increase the pressure to 280 m. So, kat sinilah dia punya melting point. Okay, this is the boiling point of H2O. Okay, so kat sini apa yang perlu awak tahu adalah triple point. Pada triple point, okay, at this pressure and temperature, kita ada mixtures of the three phases, solid, liquid and gas at equilibrium. Okay, while at point C, this is the critical point yang menunjukkan kalau kita increase pressure tu makin tinggi sekalipun, liquid dah takkan bertukar menjadi gas. Okay. So kalau contoh kita nak baca how phase changes at constant pressure, so we draw a horizontal line, okay, meaning that the pressure is kept constant. So from the first here, from the first point here, first H2O exists in the form of solid. Then when it reaches this line, it exists as solid and liquid at equilibrium. Okay, when we increase the temperature furthermore, so kita ada liquid at liquid sahaja dalam ni. Okay, then kalau kita increase lagi temperature and reaches this line here, so we have mixtures of liquid and gas at equilibrium, and finally kita akan ada gas at equilibrium. So macam yang awak nampak, the triple point of H2O is below 180 m. So bawah 180 m baru kita akan ada mixtures of solid, liquid and gas of H2O at equilibrium. So macam mana pula kalau kita change the kalau kita nak baca phase diagram ni at constant temperature, so meaning that we draw a vertical line somewhere. Okay, so first we have gas. Okay, bila kita increase lagi the pressure, So at this point kita akan ada mixtures of gas and liquid at equilibrium. Okay, then increase lagi pressure. Okay, so we have liquid. Okay, so the reason kenapa bahagian sini solid, sini liquid dan sini gas ada diterangkan dalam video kuliah ya. Now let's look at phase diagram of CO2. Okay, so sama macam tadi, on this side we have solid, on this side we have liquid and we have gas here. Okay, the reason is mentioned in the lecture video. Okay, so kalau kita tengok kat sini, sama macam tadi, garisan AT ni is the line that separate between solid and gas. So meaning that this line represent the sublimation point at different pressure and temperature. Okay, while line TB separate between solid and liquid. So these are all the melting point at different pressure and temperature. Okay, while this one here is represent the boiling point of CO2 at different pressure and also temperature. So sebenarnya phase diagram ni kita dapat daripada experimental data. Okay, so contohlah kita ada a container of CO2 sama macam tadi, cuma kita ada CO2 lah. So dalam container tu, first kita ada CO2 in the form of solid. So let's say kita keep constant the pressure at 5.2 atm. So when we increase the temperature towards the right, okay, so from solid, okay, so finally when it reaches this point, kita akan ada mixtures of solid, liquid and gas of CO2 at equilibrium. So this is called the triple point. So kalau kita increase lagi the temperature at constant pressure at 5.2 atm, so kita akan ada CO2 gas sahaja dalam container tersebut. So contoh kalau kita ambil point ke atas ni pula, somewhere above 5.2 atm. Okay, so starting from CO2 solid in the container, so as we increase the temperature, so at this point we will get mixtures of solid and liquid of CO2 at equilibrium. Then kalau kita increase lagi temperature, so kita akan ada liquid of CO2 in the container. So maksudnya pressure dia mesti lebih daripada 5.2 atm lah. So as we increase the temperature again, so kita akan ada liquid and gas of CO2 at equilibrium. And finally, after this line, kita akan ada CO2 sahaja dalam container tersebut. So semua data ni datang daripada experimental data. So for example, contoh kalau kita ambil 1 atm. Okay, 1 atm of this container. So kita increase the temperature, so dia nak tengok kat mana perubahan antara solid ke gas. So contoh dia dapat detect pada 195 Kelvin. So kat sini plot lah titik tu. Okay, so dia nak detect pula kat mana ada mixtures of the three phases at equilibrium. So after experiment, we detect that it occur at 5.2 atm and the temperature is 216 Kelvin. Okay, so kat sini dapatlah titik ni. So kat situlah kita akan sambungkan titik-titik ni menjadi satu curve. Okay, so now let's look at how to read the phase diagram at constant temperature. So kat sini kita akan draw vertical line lah somewhere. Kat sini boleh, kat sini pun boleh, bergantung pada soalan. So at this point here, first we have gas of CO2. As we increase the pressure, okay, so particle makin rapat. Okay, so kat sini dia akan mula membentuk liquid lah. Mula membentuk liquid. Okay, so at this line, we have liquid and gas of CO2 at equilibrium. Okay, then as we increase the pressure furthermore, so kita akan ada liquid sahaja dalam container tersebut. Okay, so beza yang ketara antara phase diagram of CO2 and H2O. So as we can see, for CO2, the line TB lies towards the right. So ini yang kita panggil sebagai positive gradient. Positive gradient. Kenapa berlaku positive gradient? So garisan ni menunjukkan bila pressure increase, melting point also increase. Okay, so sepatutnya bila pressure increase, susunan partikel akan menjadi semakin rapat. So the IMF becomes stronger. So it is more difficult to break the intermolecular force. So that is for CO2 and most substance. But for H2O, as we can see here, the line TB lies towards the left. Sebab water kan dia anomalous kan, the line. As we increase the pressure, okay, the IMF becomes weaker. So it causes the melting point to decrease. Okay, so maksudnya bila untuk water, as the pressure increase, the melting point will decrease. Sebab intermolecular force dia akan menjadi semakin lemah. Okay, so itu penjelasan kenapa the phase diagram of H2O has negative gradient. Other than that, the other reason is because ice is less dense than water. Okay, disebabkan oleh bila pressure increase, dia punya volume akan menjadi, bila pressure increase, volume dia akan menjadi increase juga. Okay, so itu menyebabkan IMF-nya lemah lah.